Hey Aquarius, this is Alicia with Twisted Tarot here to do your March 2019 Twin Flame Tarot reading. If you saw the first video, that is your energy. The second video is your twin's energy. I break them up into two videos because they are pretty long. Thank you everyone for all your likes, shares, subscribes, comments. You're amazing. I could not do this without you. I mean, I could. It wouldn't be as fun, but I love the support that you guys have given me for my channel. It is massive. And I love you guys so much for everything, for supporting me from the beginning. We have over 600 subscribers now, which is awesome. So yay. Thank you guys so much. Remember, guys, it is a general reading, so take what resonates, leave the rest. If you are not getting the messages that you want from my readings, the best way to get something specific to your situation is a personal reading. Or maybe you haven't liked or commented or subscribed or shared. All those things will get your energy in when I pull for the collective. So try that. I don't just do twin flames. So the link is in the description box below for my personal information. Takes you to my website. I do any type of reading. So you want to talk about money or love or your twin. There are rates based on the time frame that you book me for or the type of reading that you're looking for. So there's that. Let's see. The roles can definitely be reversed. So take it that way. If you're like, oh, that's my twin's energy and not mine, that's fine. That does happen. Okay. So don't worry about it. It is normal. And, sometimes they flip flop. Excuse me. As I was shuffling, I was just doing my clarifying deck here, guys. I was just shuffling twice. The deck fell over like this, and the Eight of Swords was there twice. I mean, it literally just like went boop, and there it was each time. So I feel like it's a message for you guys. So I want to express that for the collective. I don't know if it was for you or for your twin. I feel like it was just a general message for Aquarians. So it could be that you or your twin is feeling very restricted or have self-imposed ideas of like a victim mentality in a situation. Because if you remember with the Eight of Swords, the gal is, blindfolded and surrounded by eight swords, but she's not able to take off the blindfold or get out of her situation or grab one of those swords and walk right out. So honestly, it could be something that you feel you've imposed on yourself. It could be isolating. It could be negative thoughts. So keep that in mind. That may be something that you may be dealing with. And they wanted to, they really wanted to say something about that. So obviously, so there's that. All right, so let's get into your reading here. I'm going to chime my time, and then we're going to get into your twin side of the reading and get some more information about the connection. All right. If you're wearing headphones, you might want to take them off. I don't know how loud it can get, but it may, may be too loud for that chime if you're wearing headphones. All right, beautiful. All right. So the twin sign you could be dealing with on this sign, on this side we have Pisces, Aquarius, Leo. I didn't say this before, but we had the moon reversed on Aquarius' side, another Piscean card. Some people see it as Cancer. We had Cancer here too as well. And we had Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini. We had double Gemini here. If your twin's energy does not come out, like the sign does not come out, doesn't mean that this reading can't be for you. It just may resonate with those signs do connect, that do come out. But remember, it's general, guys. Any sign can pop up at any time as I'm doing the reading. So, and we don't need to get kind of stuck on the signs either, because it's, remember, we have intricate charts. So our moons, my moon falls in Aquarius, and your guys' planets are going to fall into different astrological signs as well. So sometimes this can be those planets coming out as well for the reading. So it doesn't necessarily mean, oh, that's what their sun sign is. All right, so the mutual energy between you and your twin is the lepers. Ooh, so pretty. Could be dealing with a Gemini here. So what I'm feeling like this is duality, but also a beautiful sense of You and your twin may just be really coming into union for a lot of you. You may be learning about this twin flame journey, maybe learning about that this is your twin for some of you. You may not have even known that before. I feel like for some of you, it's a kind of maybe new. Maybe it's challenging everything you thought you knew about relationships. For those of you that are not in, that are in separation, this could also be in the higher realms. Okay, so in the 5D, etc. So you could be experiencing the union there. I feel like this is kind of, these two snakes are trying to kind of learn each other, okay? And they're trying to learn about this journey in a way that kind of intertwines them, like they know they're the two halves of the whole. Could also be a choice. So it could be a choice between a karmic and your twin or a soulmate and your twin. For some of you, either on your side or your twin side, either way, it could be a choice. A choice to pursue other options. Sometimes the lover is seen as that within relationships. But I think it's a beautiful twin flame card, and I'm loving this energy for you guys. I clarified that card out, and we have the Five of Swords. Okay, so I feel like a lot of you are defending this connection, or you're trying to keep people away from it. You're trying to figure things out for yourself. You're trying to figure out where you stand with this person, where they stand with you, kind of. Maybe just like you guys want to be in your love nest and you want people to just leave you the hell alone, and that's fine. And maybe you're trying to protect this connection against outside influences. We do have the Three of Cups here twice, once upright and once reversed. So it is possible there was a third party interference or past interference, okay? Doesn't have to be a person. Remember that it could be just a situation. It could be drugs or alcohol, okay? So take it how it resonates. All right, first card out, we have Prince. Ooh, that's so cute. Light attribute, romantic charm and potential for power. So your twin may be very charming. They may be bringing you flowers. They may be acting just like this. But a prince, remember, isn't a king. So they could be younger, or they could be, you know, 20s, 30s, etc. Or just in maturity level. But I feel like this is beautiful. They have romantic charm, and this could charm the birds out of the trees, you guys. And they show this power within themselves and within you. So they're able to kind of woo you. So that's really beautiful. It doesn't have to be feminine energy, but it is a very masculine energy with the prince here. So this could even be a feminine who has these same traits, okay? So don't get hung up on that. It could also be somebody who's a mother who has a little prince. Maybe she calls her little boy a little prince. I talk to my little boy that way, so that could be it as well. We have activate intuition, be a clear channel, access the Akashic records, stay grounded, feel protected and safe, promote clarity in the dream time. Okay, interesting. Okay, so for some of you, if you're trying to activate your intuition, and be a clearer channel for messages. They want you to get some lapis lazuli, or lazuli, I guess. I'm not sure how you say that last one. But this will help you feel grounded, protected, safe, and this will help you clarify some of your dreams, okay? They also want you to look into the Akashic Records. This is associated with the message of, I receive messages all the time and follow my internal guidance system. Very beautiful. Very blue energy on this side. So your twin may like to wear blue, or it is their favorite color. They have blue eyes. We have kitchen. Creation. Okay. So some of them may be really, they really may have talents in the kitchen. They may be good around the kitchen, maybe good at, you know, maybe they're helpful in the kitchen. Maybe they clean, or they have talents like cooking, or they can remodel something. And it has to do with kitchens, like kitchen remodeling. Maybe that's what their profession is. But that's very beautiful here. I love that. And the kitchen's kind of where you kind of go to eat sometimes too. Like, I mean, it might be the living room, but you know, this is where all the food and the magic happens, is in the kitchen. So, wow, beautiful. Guys may be doing it in the kitchen, just saying. yeah, let's see. JK. Oh. Ooh, excuse me. Creation. Okay. It's time for you to start creating new dishes, such as relationships or opportunities to feed yourself. Start assembling the ingredients for your goals or spicing things up. The kitchen card symbolizes the place where you cook, create, socialize, and nourish yourself. Yeah, absolutely, you guys. It is associated with Archangels Jophiel and Haniel. Close friends and family members are there to comfort or support you. Ask them for assistance. Clean up your environment by removing clutter, employing feng shui, and donating items you no longer need. External disorder is reflected in your internal life. Add variety to your daily social routine. So you may want to start entertaining more or being more social, or you already do those things. And they kind of want you to clean up your act, maybe. Clean up your home. Get rid of clutter. Because again, a cluttery mind is a reflection of a cluttery life. So that kind of energy is blocking you in some way from creation as well. They want you to start new relationships. They want you to talk to new people and get out there and be social as well. And even inviting them over for a meal is very beautiful. So if you want to do that, that's absolutely great energy. I'm loving that. We have recognition. So your twin recognizes this connection. Okay, that's why that lovers is here. It's possible it's causing them a lot of stress here. I mean, that Five of Swords is all about thoughts too. So maybe they just learned that this is, you are their twin, and it's put them into like kind of a like, or maybe they're not 100% on board, but they recognize something to do with this connection is very, very poignant. Okay, so there's something not to be ignored here, and they know that, okay? For a lot of them, they're recognizing you as being a very beautiful, a very divine connection between the two of you. I'm also itching. So I don't know if a lot of you are having some allergies to something in your environment. It could be to dairy. You know, all I'm doing is drinking coffee and with creamer in it. So, but pay attention. You might have some allergies. I know I'm having them, so I don't know what's going on. But it is really hot today. Maybe everything's kind of, you know, up in the air and getting on my skin or whatever. So maybe you're itchy. So if you are, I'm sorry. I'm picking up on it or whatever. Like, whoop. All right. We have the Nine of Cups. Oh, maybe this was your wish that they would recognize this connection. Maybe you've been wishing all along for them to recognize who you are. Or maybe you put all your wishes into something like this, into having a connection this beautiful. And that's amazing. So this is trying to figure out your path as well, kind of putting like your emotional, it may make you very emotional at this time. I mean, you may be kind of trying to deal with those emotions in the best way possible. I feel like you're so close to getting what you want with this Nine of Cups that you just need one more cup for that Ten of Cups. And this may be this recognition of this connection. For some of you, it's like you may have been wishing, praying, or hoping for this person. For a twin or for someone to come in and love you, which is just beautiful. Hold on, my dog's being ridiculous. Get in here. Super. Okay. Sorry about that. Okay. All right. And for those of you that know how I read, I clarify all the tarot cards at the end. All right, we have a tea leaf connection, bread, period of prosperity and abundance. Okay, yeah, I feel like you want to break bread with people. You want to bring people into your environment. You want to entertain. You want to have good food, good wine. You know, those type of, that energy is what I'm feeling. I'm seeing people around the kitchen table. I'm seeing people helping you cook. I'm seeing wine and bread and butter and just, you know, food. So it's just beautiful energy. I'm loving this. But you're entering a time of prosperity and abundance, especially with this Nine of Cups. Like, they're like, you're getting everything you're wishing for. You know, you are so there. Twin flame message. The grass wasn't greener on the other side. Yeah. So they may have thought, oh, well, I'm going to go out and date and find someone better than you or better than this connection. Or they didn't know what you were at the time, that you were twins. And they were like, you know, it's not, you know, maybe they were like, oh, my. Yeah. They did not get what they bargained for. Okay. For some of them. Card is child, orphan. All right, but it is reverse here, guys. We're going to take the shadow attribute. Feelings of abandonment that stifle maturation, seeking inappropriate surrogate families. Okay, for some of you, your attachment with your parents may have not been very secure. Okay, if you're not sure what that is, you can look up attachment theory. It is well known in the in my field of counseling and family therapy, it is a very interesting concept that needs to be explored to kind of understand how we attach to others, how we feel how others may abandon us, we abandon them first, or just the way that we were shown attachment when we were younger. If we didn't have secure attachments, it can bleed into our other relationships, including friendships, the way, you know, we interact with other family members, even siblings, etc. So it may be that this is a huge fear for your twin. They're afraid of being abandoned, okay? And they're afraid of abandonment. So they may be the first ones to be like, boop, bye. And they may have, you know, thought, oh, the grass was greener on the other side, or I don't believe in this connection, or I'm not sure about it at first. And then, you know, they were shown the way, okay? Or they realized that, no, it wasn't better on the other side, okay? So this could stifle them maturity-wise. So this could be why they show up as a prince and not a king here, okay? Understand the underlying causes of challenges in relationships. Balance the mind and emotions. Good connections with supportive friends and family. That may be exactly what they need to understand their ability to attach or connect to others, to try and work through that, to try and figure out healthy ways of secure attachments, especially to you, Aquarius, you and your twin may need to relearn that, okay, as an adult. But they also need to understand the causes of challenges in their relationships, what they're responsible for, what others are responsible for, that type of information. Okay, and this can be done with Unikite. I think I have some of that. I believe this is Unikite. It even has the pink right there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's beautiful. I'll keep this out for you guys in this reading because it seems like this is really important for you guys. My emotions are balanced. I react to others in an objective and loving way. Yeah. Awesome. Okay. Nettle, boundaries and caution. Okay. So I feel like for a lot of you, it may be that because your twin, if they do have attachment issues specifically, that are rooted in childhood, okay, or rooted in how they grew up, okay, and primary caregivers, how they related to them, how they felt secure or insecure or disorganized in relationships. This could help. This could give them an unhealthy boundaries. Okay, they either have too lax of boundaries, or they're too like secure in their boundaries. Like nobody gets in, like nobody can get in, or they're just like too many people get in. Okay, and then they cause problems. It could be that they're feeling responsible for others when it's not their problem, okay? And they have maybe loose boundaries when it comes to protecting themselves from people who are not good for them, okay? So this is a cautionary card, okay? So let's look this up. This is nettle. I believe this grows in my yard, honestly. I'm not sure. This could be the wrong thing. I think it's the one that has like all the little spikes, little pokey things on it, but I could be wrong. If somebody knows, write that in the comments. This card is warning you to maintain your boundaries. There is a situation that needs to be approached with caution and respect. Heed the red flags, be gentle with yourself, and take care to protect yourself. Nettle is a plant of maternal and metaphysical protection that encourages adaptability and flexibility. This herb helps shield you from harmful energies. It provides deep nourishment. Teaches healthy boundaries and keeps away negativity and danger. Okay. I believe this is a weed that I've got in my yard, and I just kept it out front because I'm like, I want to keep myself protected. I'm a weirdo, I know. All right. And this is associated with Archangels Michael, Raphael, and Haniel. Consider drinking nettle tea for blood health and stimulating nourishment. Okay, for some of you, if you're having some issues with your heart or with your circulation possibly, drinking nettle tea might help with that as well. I'm not a doctor. Please do not come at me with, well, what about? No, literally, I'm not recommending that you do that without talking to your doctor first, okay? So whatever medications you're on, you know, anything that I say in here is always going to have that type of cautionary energy with it, okay? So, talk to your doctor. Say, hey, a tarot reader or whatever. You don't have to say you're a tarot reader. So I might look at you funny, but they want me to, or somebody recommended nettle, you know, could I take this? You need to be more adaptable and flexible in this current environment. Yeah. So I feel like it's almost like Have you ever played that game where it's like, I can't remember, but it's the stick and two people hold it on each side and they go lower and lower and lower. I cannot remember what it's called, but it kind of feels like that, but almost in your life. Like, it's almost like people turn to kind of block you at every direction. And again, it's having healthy boundaries with those people. It's almost like they are intentionally trying to mess with you. And if you allow them to, it just, what you allow continues. Okay. So try and be aware of that. Okay. Try and get some healthy boundaries going with the people around you. Or sticking with your boundaries, and making sure that they're consistent and never changing. Because as soon as you let somebody change that boundary, even if you've made it, as soon as you change that boundary with them, they will push and push until you don't have one anymore, okay? So consistency is key. Lessons. Yeah, this is a lesson, for sure. This recognition of your twin is a lesson, okay? And you're going to learn something from this, learning to put up boundaries, learning the knowledge of attachment theory as well. Interesting. Yeah, and we have the Ten of Cups reversed, okay? So you had the Nine of Cups here. So maybe you were wishing for something, maybe in the past, and it didn't work out. So this could have been a marriage, a relationship that you were unhappy and unsatisfied with, okay? So maybe you've acknowledged that, okay? Maybe this relationship has ended. It could be a divorce. It could be it could be you just broke it off if you weren't married or engaged or whatever, and you just ended the relationship, or it ended, okay? But there was something about this that was, there was a lesson in this, okay? There was a lesson in, it's almost like first marriages, my stepmom says, are like a trial run. Like, they're meant to be kind of like that test drive, okay, for some people. It's kind of like figuring out, okay, what went wrong and how in the future not to make that same mistake, but also in picking partners, how we pick partners based on our previous relationships. It also goes back to attachment again, guys. So it's also about and having good boundaries. So maybe it was teaching you a lesson in this to have better boundaries in the future and to make sure that, you know, you can distinguish what's good for you and what's not in relationships in the future. So that's very interesting. We have romances in the air. Yeah, I feel like there's romance in the air for this, for your twin. Yeah, they definitely are feeling that romance, you know. And it's possible that, you know, after their marriage ended or after a relationship or after they were disappointed emotionally with a relationship, more than likely, now romance is kind of blooming, okay? So maybe that, you know, your twin now realizes who you are. And that's with that recognition, okay? And that was the lesson. But now there's just romance in the air between you guys, especially with the Lover's card. I feel like, you know, you guys may be, you know, there's some romantic communication is going on for some of you. Very beautiful. And we have twin flame message. I'm not the same person that you remember. Okay, so maybe that you remember this person being, you know, maybe they've changed, okay? And then, you know, they've grown. Next message is networker, but it's reversed, okay? So this is what it looks like upright and reversed. Okay, so this talks about communication. Shadow attribute, conveys information only for personal gain, spreads fear and falsehood. Very possible that it's not necessarily, it could be your energy, it could be someone around you, keep that in mind. But it could be that the information that someone's around you, they're spreading rumors or lies or things about you that are false, okay? Just have to put it out there. They're doing it for personal gain. They're trying to make themselves look better, okay? But you may be doing the same thing. You may be like, you know, this person, you know, it could be this relationship that ended. It could be that, you know, you're just like, you know, you may just be over embellishing, or you may just outright be spreading something that's false about them, because you're hurt or you're angry. And, you know, sometimes that happens when we get in those lower vibrations with people, and we sometimes lash out the same way that we're, you know, that's not healthy, but it does happen. It could also be that there is information that you thought was correct and whatever, but it just, when you express it, that it just causes fear in other people. Or your information that you feel is correct may cause fear in others. You know, there's a lot of things going on in society today where we don't know, you know, journalism is being restricted and political political freedom and our ability to have conversations with people has been severely restricted by everybody not doing their research and not understanding, you know, how communication works in a respectful manner. Gosh, I can't express that anymore. All right, next card we have. Activate the creative mind. Finalize projects. Realize unlimited potential. Improve visualization skills. Stimulate the courage to fulfill life purpose and potential. All right, yeah, so if you're trying to activate your creativity, if you're trying to finish up projects, if you're trying to improve, they want you to improve your visualization skills and to fulfill your life purpose and potential, you can do this with Carnelian. That's beautiful. That's actually one stone I don't have. Creativity flows through me in myriad ways. I courageously bring my ideas into actuality. Okay, yeah. You guys might want to pick some of that up. We have school and lessons. We have two cards here about lessons. So you may be wanting to go back to school and learn something, or life is like a school right now. It's teaching you lessons about yourself and about some of the things you may be challenging your beliefs as well, and wants you to do the research, okay? A lot of you just need to do that research. Let's see what it says here in the book. This is from the Angel Dreams Oracle card deck, if I didn't say that earlier. I always like to read from here because honestly, guys, I cannot remember all of the information. I don't use every deck every day. There's just no way. I have 70 decks. And I like when things come up and I don't know what they mean. So I can look them up for you. And sometimes I pick up parts that are different in the meanings. And sometimes this gives more meaning than I ever could do from memory. School represents the lessons you're learning at this moment in your life. This dream card asks you to notice if you are learning at an elementary or university level. Who is helping you with your lessons? Acknowledge those teachers and mentors. Take time to find the answers or solutions so you can graduate. For example, perhaps you dream of being in first grade, trying to solve a math equation. The teacher is guiding you through the problem. You could interpret this to mean that you are at a beginning level of this lesson in your life. You're trying to solve an issue that has you stumped. Your dream might be telling you what you need to ask for help. Telling you that you need to ask for help. Okay, so for some of you, you may need to ask for help from others, and your dreams may be, you may be learning something and you may not know how to resolve something, so they're asking you to ask for help. Or one in which you forget your homework might be a sign that you're panicking over something that could easily be resolved. Okay, so again, could be panicking over this twin flame journey, how to do this. If you just found out who your twin was, this could also be a lesson for you, and you're learning something about this, okay, and embracing this path for some of you. You're trying to resolve something. You're trying to understand it, okay? Archangel Zadkiel is associated with this symbol. Before bedtime, focus on a situation with the intention to have your lessons revealed in your dreams. So, yeah, you can set your intentions for your dream before you dream, before you fall asleep. You can say, I want to dream about the solution to my problem. And there you go. You can put your attention out there, go to sleep. I did it the other day and it totally worked. So, I highly recommend that. If you dreamed of school, notice that what you were learning as it represents symbolically or literally the lesson of this moment If you dreamed of school, notice what you were learning as it represents the lesson or this moment or a particular situation. Symbolically or literally. So you could get a dream guide, a dream book, and look up your dreams and especially, you know, figure out what the dream means. So if you are dreaming about being in school, it could literally mean you need to go back to school, or you're thinking about going back to school, or you're trying to resolve a problem with school. Maybe you're in school right now and you're doing your work right now, or you're trying to finish up a degree, or just thinking about going back to pursue a degree. But you may be having dreams about school. I have them all the time. I hate them. I super hate them. They're awful. But they may be trying to teach us something. Okay. So look them up, online. You can do a search or in a dream journal, a dream guidebook, like a symbol dream, and journal your dreams. Okay. So I didn't say that by accident. Yeah. Journaling will help. And then you can symbolically look up all the symbols of your dream and what they mean. And you learned your lesson about a karmic partner. You are no longer with a karmic partner. So on this side, I feel like you have learned your lesson with this karmic partner. You now recognize the lesson with them. You also recognize your twin. You also recognize that this was just karmic. You realize that this doesn't need, that you don't need this person anymore, that you've learned your lesson, okay? Wow, you learned your lesson when it comes to that karmic partner. And I do believe for a lot of you that that karmic partner is no longer an issue within your twin flame dynamic. For some of you, it's moving forward with just you and your twin. So I'm so proud of you guys, so proud. Okay, and then we have strength reversed. Again, Leo card here, okay? For a lot of you, it's trying to come to some type of conclusion about overcoming some issues within this connection still. So you may still be trying to unentangle yourself from this person, from this relationship, from the way it ended. You may be trying to have the strength to kind of overcome your fears within this new connection with the twin, with your twin flame. It could also be that you just lack the strength to continue on with this crap, you know, that you're just, you're done. For a lot of you, you're just like, okay, I'm over it. Like, I have, this relationship has ended, or it is no longer in my life, and there was a lesson here to be learned. I learned the lesson. Okay, so I'm just wanting to move on, but I just don't feel like I have the strength right now. So for a lot of you, I feel like it's trying to tame that beast, and you may be letting that beast kind of take over you instead of allowing it to, and instead of being able to tame it and kind of understand the and it could be the masculine's taking over in you, and it's almost like pulling you in one direction as well. So it's almost like the masculine may be out of balance for you. Now, I know the masculine was needed to be utilized more in your twin and your in the Aquarius side. So that could be why. It could be that you're very focused on your masculine side over here, and that could be being picked up by your picked up on by your twin. All right. Well, great worry over nothing. Yeah, you may be worrying over this over nothing, that this is going to resolve itself. Okay, so a lot of you that you're learning the lesson, or you're trying to learn this lesson, or you will be learning this lesson about this karmic situation, about your twin, about having the strength to move forward, but you may be worried. Yeah, you may be very worried at this time, but they're telling you it's over little stuff. That stuff isn't going to matter, you know, 3 or 6 months from now, that it's all going to kind of work itself out is what I feel like, okay? And you will find the strength. I believe that a lot of you will find the strength, and this will change and maybe it's because this karmic partner just keeps, you know, putting you through the lessons, okay? It's almost like when you think things are done, especially with a divorce or the end of a relationship, sometimes that person can just continuously keep acting fool. In my situation, that continues to this day. And it's almost like the idiocracy just can't get any, it's like, what are you going to do next? Like, you know, and I feel like sometimes that's what happens when partners end. And it can happen months down the road. It's still happening, and I am a year and a half out from my divorce. So, you know, just keep in mind that, you know, the lessons just keep coming and they test your strength. I feel like they're testing your strength over and over. This karmic partner just keeps testing your strength, keeps testing you. Okay. And you just have to keep showing up. Okay, guys, just keep going. Okay. You're going to make it through this time frame. I do fully feel that. Twin flame message. I don't know if I can meet your expectations. You could be worrying about whether you could meet your twin flame's expectations. All right. Let's do some clarifying here. We've got the Nine of Cups. Okay. All right. Let's see what's going on with that Nine of Cups. Why is the Nine of Cups here? Six of Cups almost fell out. Okay. Three of Wands. Okay, so it kind of came out crazily, so I'm going to take it. It came out sideways. So you're trying to figure out whether you should wait or not. Wait around for these wishes. Wait around for this person, possibly. I feel like you're recognizing something, or you're wanting someone to recognize this connection, or you are. But it's almost like, you know, you're waiting to see if your wishes are going to be fulfilled. I feel like for a lot of you, you're kind of waiting to see if your wishes are going to be fulfilled with this person. Like, you kind of sent out the love and the messages and that connection. You've established that connection with them, and now you're just kind of deciding whether, you know, whether you should wait around for them, maybe just kind of stepping back and kind of observing. Maybe I know that's not on the Aquarius side. The Aquarius is taking action, but your twin may be just kind of waiting, okay, for this connection to kind of come to fruition, okay? And for their wishes and their dreams, they've maybe prayed for this, okay? Why is the Ten of Cups reversed? Okay. I'm not going to take it. I hadn't even gotten the words out. Okay, guys. Why is the Ten of Cups reversed? Why is the Ten of Cups reversed? Okay. All right, almost. Why is the Ten of Cups reversed? Just jumping. They want to just freaking come out. But yeah, why is the Ten of Cups reversed? Why is the Ten of Cups reversed? Okay. Nothing. Page of Wands. Okay. Okay. So Page of Wands reversed. I feel like, again, lessons. Okay. This is the student. This is someone who's learning something from this ending. Okay. So it could be dealing with a fire sign, Aquarius, Leo, or Sagittarius. We have Aquarius here, and you guys are Aquarius. So, anyways, slip of the tongue, but if it matters, you know, to you and it makes sense, and great. But Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, okay, but could be younger. Doesn't have to be, just could be that energy, but someone who's immature with their communication, immature with their ability to, they really couldn't offer you this, okay? So it's almost like now you know that they just could not offer you a happy home. It wasn't a happy home. There were some lessons to be learned from it, though. Could be a child involved for some of you. Maybe your child is acting out because of the divorce, or they're having some anger and outbursts and things like that. So for some of you, it could be a child. For some of you, it's a person involved in the situation, possibly a younger fire sign. Doesn't have to be, but it's that energy of just aggression, immaturity, like, you never know what they're going to say or do next. And it's like, it always just brings more crap. Okay. So it's always just, it just reinforces the fact why you guys are not together or why this has ended for some of you. And it's this surprise every single, I told you, like, they just push the envelope every time, and they keep testing your strength. I feel like for a lot of you, they just keep testing your strength over and over and over again within this connection. Okay. Why is the Strength card reversed? Why is the Strength card reversed? Okay. All right. So it's possible, okay, this is clarified by the Page of Cups and the Seven of Cups. That Page of Cups almost fell out on top of the Ten of Cups. Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces energy here with the Page of Cups. And then we have the Seven of Cups, okay? A lot of emotions here. Okay, so I feel like for some of you, the person keeps testing you because they keep showing you that they have a ton of options and shoving them in your face, and they're unapologetic about it for some of you, even though this Page of Cups is upright, okay? For others of you, I feel like you may lack the strength to offer a full commitment to someone else or to offer this Page of Cups, like this beautiful cup of love. It may be a small offer of love, and you may have options, or they may have options. So you're not sure if you have the strength to kind of, offer this love or to put it into motion. I feel like for some of you, it's confusion. You may be confused by this person. You may be confused by this Page of Cups. They may be offering you love 1 minute, but you're not sure about them. Like, you're not sure that you have the strength to offer it back. Or if you do have, you're lacking some type of ability to offer something more than the Page of Cups. And you may be confused about who to offer it to. So you may have other options in this dynamic. I feel like for a lot of you, you want to offer your love, but there's so much confusion. There's so many things that you're just, it's just like you're overwhelmed in your mind. And it's just like all these cups, all these cups look great. What am I, you know? And it's like trying to figure out which cup you want to, do you want to offer your cup to this person? Do you want to offer this love? Do you have the strength to do that? Okay. Because you're just being tested over and over and over again within this other, with this karmic partner. Okay. And it could be that the person, again, Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces, that they keep testing your strength and they keep showing you that they have other options and they keep making bad. I feel like this person tests your strength and they keep making bad choices. They keep kind of making emotionally charged decisions, and they're just as confused, or they're confusing you, because one day is one thing, the next day it's a different thing. For some of you, you may be wanting an apology from someone for their options, for what they've done. So if they cheated on you, which is very possible here, I don't know why I'm feeling that, but it is possible that if they cheated on you, or if they are rubbing another relationship in your face, that you're just like, you know, why can't you just grow up? It's almost like this very immature energy with this Page of Cups here. It's like, you know, you want them to kind of maybe come to you with their offer, but they may have a lot of options, or you do. And that scares them away too. This is that strength card. So there's lots of messages here. So take whatever resonates for you guys. All right, guys, we have your fortune card here. Da-da-da-da. We have plane. Oh yeah. A journey is indicated either physically or metaphorically. Your life will become more full. I do believe that. I do believe you guys are on this journey, this twin flame journey, and that your life is going to become more full. It may be physically, and it may be, or it may be metaphorically. I see that very strongly on your side, Aquarius, and I do feel like there's some lessons that are being learned on your twin side as well. So, you know, definitely a journey towards recognition too here with this recognition card. So congratulations, you guys. If you're coming into union, I am so happy for you. So happy for you. All right, take care, and I will see you for your April videos.